Perhaps this simple defeat of this little so-called champion will be a perfect example of how pathetic, weak your society has become. We go.
Tell me a little bit about Michael Pataki, who plays that Russian. He's such a significant part of this movie.
He's a great character actor who mastered accents. He just came in there and tore it up, and I thought he was the real deal. I thought he was from Siberia, Moscow. He just was a complete surprise and embraced everything and just dominated so much that I kept writing more and more and more dialogue for him. So he just killed it.
Shall we have a demonstration?
Please do.
Thank you. As you can see, Drago averages 1,850 pounds. So the result's quite obvious. Whatever he hits, he destroys.
Connect that to Dolph Lundgren.
I think he trusted me, and I guess it paid off because he's still considered one of the top three villains of all time, without being a real villain.
I must break you.
You told this Dolph Lundgren, why don't you send your picture to Sylvester Stallone?
Well, he actually he went home. I told him to go home.
Went home, came back to the restaurant, gave me the photo, and then you shipped it to me, right, or someone.
I brought it to you.
You brought it to me. So your memory's better than mine. And I went, wow. Light bulb goes off, news flash, bolt of lightning. I go, wow. And I completely changed the script at that second. I went, all right, original concept, gone. New concept. Drago is the future. He's not a primitive. He's the future. He's science. He's evolved 1,000 years where man should be. Perfect, intelligent, flawless. And I thought, the audience, my God, they're going to see something they've never seen before, because no one had ever seen anyone like Dolph Lundgren before. Not only is he, you know, 6'5" and a half, like IQ of 160, 65 plus, you know, you're talking about a chemical engineer and a Fulbright scholar. This is like, you know, come on. So he was the embodiment of that.
Do you know what everybody says? That it's suicide. You've seen him. You know how strong he is. You can't win.
Let's talk for a second about Talia Shire.
I don't think that she was ever given the full credit for the success of the whole Rocky series, because without her, there is no him. He just wanted to redeem himself, that he wasn't a bum from the neighborhood, and that in his eyes, he could look in the mirror and go, well, I amounted to something. And that was due to her. He finally had something to live for, something to protect. And she, with her incredible understated acting ability, embodied an entire silent majority of women that kind of live in this pressure cooker existence and never really get to blossom. And you see her blossom. You see her literally go from a dying plant to a rose. Acting with her is like being against a great changeup pitcher. It's gonna be a curve, a slider, a fastball, like a jazz woodwind. She's up and down.
I'm with you no matter what.
Really incredible. They got very, very lucky.